students, in this class I'll be doing class 10 CBSE syllabus, 5th chapter, arithmetic progressions. Already one exercise I have completed, second exercise I will continue. 15th sum, for what values of n are the nth terms of 2 APs? So 2 APs are given, are equal. For what value of n, both the APs are equal. Okay, so the first AP given as 63, 65, 67, it is given like this. Then second AP, 3, 10, 17, like that it will go, or equal. Okay, so this AN and this AN are equal, so we have to find what N is equal. Okay, so for finding that, here A is equal to 63, D is equal to 65 minus 63, that is equal to 2. So we know that AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. A plus N minus 1 into D. So AN is equal to A is 63 plus N minus 1 into D is given as 2. Okay. So this is equal to 63 plus 2n minus 2. So this is equal to 61 plus 2n. So an is equal to 61 plus 2n is for the first AP. Same thing we have to do for the second AP also. A is equal to 3. D is equal to 10 minus 3. That is equal to 7. So an is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So A value is given as 3 plus N minus 1 into D is 7. So this is equal to 3 plus 7N minus 7. So this is equal to 7N minus 4. So AN is equal to 7N minus 4. So here AN is equal to 61 plus 2N. Here AN is equal to 7N minus 4. In the question it is given, they are equal. So both the AN are equal. So equating, so we'll take this as the first one and this as the second one. Equating 1 and 2. Equating 1 and 2. Equating 1 and 2. So 61 plus 2N is equal to 7N minus 4. So 61, we'll bring this n this side. So 2n minus 7n is equal to minus 4 minus 61. So minus 5n is equal to minus 65. So minus will get cancelled. N is equal to 65 by n, 5, that is equal to 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. So n is equal to 13. So for what values of n? The given nth terms of 2 APs are equal. So for n is equal to 13, both the APs are equal. Next sum is, determine the AP whose third term is 16 and seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. So these are the two conditions given. We are asked to find the AP. That is the sequence we are asked to find. So for that we need A, D and R. Then only we can find. For finding that A and D only, these two information is given. So third term, so A3 is equal to 16. Okay, then seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. Seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. So the difference between the seventh term and the fifth term is 12. So these are the two conditions given. Okay, so this one we can write it as, first one, A3 is equal to 16, we can write it as A plus 2D is equal to 16. Then this one, A plus 6D minus A plus 4D is equal to 12. So A plus 6D minus A minus 4D is equal to 12. So plus A minus A get cancelled. So 4 minus 6 minus 4 is 2. So 2D is equal to 12 and D is equal to 6. So D is equal to 6. So we got D value as 6 here. That D value we'll substitute here and find a. So that is a plus 2d is equal to 16. So a plus 2 into 6 is equal to 16. So a plus 12 is equal to 16. So a is equal to 16 minus 12, that is equal to 4. So a value, we got it as 4. So now we know for finding an AP sequence, we need AD. So we got A and D value. Now we can write the AP. So first term is 4. 4 is the first term. Second term is A plus D. So the sequence of AP is A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D. Like this we can write. So we got A and D values, so we can find the AP. So A is 4 here, then A plus D is A plus D, so that is 4 plus 6. Then next one is A is 4 plus 2 into 6, then 4 plus 3 into 6. So like this we will write. So the answer is 4, 4 plus 6 10, then 4 plus 6 2s are 12, so 4 plus 12 is 16, then 4 plus 6 3s are 18, 18 plus 4 22. So like this we will get the answer. So this is like this we will get the APC series. Okay, 4 10 16 22 is the answer for this. Next sum is find the 20th term from the last term of the AP. 3, 8, 13. The last term given is 253. So A is given as 3 here and D is 8 minus 3, that is equal to 5. So this difference is from the first term. We are asked to find the 20th term from the last. So from the last means this will be the first term. So the difference between, so the A will be 253 that time. And then the difference will be the reverse of that. So the difference will be minus 5 here. Okay. So after that A20 we need to find out, that's all. So A20 is equal to A plus 19D. So A is 253 plus 19 into D is minus 5. Okay. So this is 253. Minus 19 into 5. 9 5s are 45. 95 we will get. Minus 95. So 253 minus 95 will be 8 5 1 158. 8 plus 5 13 15. So this is equal to 158. So the 20th term from the last is 158. Completing today's class, whatever doubts you have, you message me in the comment box. Thank you.